Take two.
Yo, people! And other such Hiawatha things. Canoeing as a sport started in Britain some 117 years ago, started by a barrister called John McGregor. And since then, it really has flourished. There are now 1.5 million canoeists in Britain. And one of the best ones is driving me at the back. His name is Dave Laurence, a former world champion and organiser of the British Canoe Exhibition at Crystal Palace. Dave, what's this machine that we're in at the moment?
This is a touring Canadian canoe. It's the sort that a family can take off down the river at a weekend with their camping equipment.
Yeah.
And just enjoy themselves in a very pleasant manner on the canals.
But nice. for the sport in canoeing, the real sort of racing and so on, I guess people would use the smaller ones that are out here. Take that red one, for instance. What's that?
Yes, that's an introductory boat that we'd use to introduce adults to the sport. Nice, stable craft that they can learn the skills involved with the sport.
Now, what's that strange-looking blue one, Dave?
Well, that's meant to go very straight in a... very fast in a straight line. It's derived from the same technology that was used to build parts of Concorde.
Yeah.
It's a 2 fiberglass skin separated by a honeycomb structure, and it makes it very rigid, immensely stiff, and it goes very... it's only half the weight of a normal boat.
Now, if someone wanted to take this up as a sport, say you're 11 or 12 years old, what's the best way?
Well, you could be introduced in the confines of a swimming pool in one of these very short boats that we have here. They're known as bat boats, and that really is the best way to learn.
Well, Annie's in one of those bat boats, so let's find out what it's all about.
Well, I am, in fact, a lot safer than I look or feel, and I'm assured that this has been built for maximum stability. It's called a BAT, which stands for Bath Advanced Trainer, and it's designed originally for use in public baths so that people could practice how to use these things without causing any harm to anyone else. As you can see at the front, there's rubber stops so that if you do go into something sharp, you're not going to hurt either yourself or the other person. It's got a completely flat bottom, which I'm told does give it more maneuverability and stability. But there's always the exception to the rule, and I think I'm about to prove it.
As you can see, canoeing is a sport quite easy to take up. There are hundreds of clubs around the country that belong to the British Canoe Union, so why not go and join up? But to see what's happening at a higher level, let's join a couple of guys in training, ready for the 1984 Olympics in Los Angeles. Here come Eric and Grayson.
Mm-hmm.